Hi, I'm David Ewing Duncan. I'm here at the Bio Investor Forum, and I'm very pleased to welcome Julia Forbus from Fenwick & West. And she's going to tell us a little bit about trends and where we're headed in the biotech industry over the next few months and next year. So, Julia, tell us about, we're almost at the end of 2017. What trends are you seeing? I mean, it's been a decent year. But what do you think?
Yeah, so deal volume has not been what we saw in 2015, 2014, but it is on par with 2016 at least. So for private financing, we're set to surpass the $6 billion in private financing that we saw last year. In the public markets, we've had 26 IPOs up through quarter three, raising a total of $2.5 billion. And so we're seeing a strong deal flow. At Fenwick & West, we've had half a dozen companies that have raised $1.5 billion in follow-on offerings as well.
Wow, I want to work for you. What about exits? That's what, you know, everybody wants to know about that. Are we looking for more exits, even with a little bit of time left this year, or what's the situation with that?
Yeah, so in the IPO market, as mentioned, there have been fewer deals, but they've been larger deals. So we've actually had an average of $96 million per IPO, just on an average basis, which is much higher than we've seen in prior years. I think that we have some well-situated companies in the pipeline. We sort of expect that to continue through the end of the year. Now with M&A, it's a little bit harder to say, a little bit harder to predict perhaps. There are a couple factors that have been leading towards IPOs over M&A, and those are there have been a greater number of crossover investors. And so those crossover investors generally have a preference for an IPO. And then again, like we saw in the private financing realm, there's been a lot of private financing money, which allows smaller companies to stay independent longer.
That can be a good thing.
Yeah, definitely.
And so now the crystal ball, just really briefly, where are we headed next year? Let's just do 1 year.
Okay. 2018. So I think we still expect to see investment in the core areas, oncology, orphan drugs, and neurology. I think we still expect to see strong investment there. One thing that could be new or is new is greater number of tech investors interested in the diagnostics and the other tools. And so with that new investment, I think we all need to ask ourselves a question about whether there'll be a change to the capital formation process and deal-making process. And along with that, I think there are more stakeholders in the ecosystem. So we used to have a very tried and true playbook, great product or platform. You get your investment through the usual suspects and then you exit. I think we all need to ask ourselves, how is that going to shift? And whether we're going to see a change in terms of pharma deals and the timing of those, regulatory strategies, and other similar issues.
So we'll see.
Exactly.
Okay. Thank you very much, Julia.
Yeah, thank you.